Another bright spot. Wow. A live look at Port Washington. Yeah, this is a different picture than we've seen over the last couple days. A dreary Wednesday, Jesse.
Dreary, wet, and much
soggy,
colder.
Squishy.
Yeah, don't go golfing today. What a good idea for that. Friday might be a little better for that because we're looking at lighter winds, drier skies by Friday, but it's going to be cold just because we're finally on the colder side. I don't know if finally is a good word, but we are finally on the cold side of this storm system. We were kind of on the warm sector the past couple of days. That led us to the 80s. Now, as the colder air starts wrapping around this area of low pressure, you can kind of see that spin right there on Viper radar. That's just telling us that, yeah, the colder air is wrapping in, so we'll be looking at a couple chances for some of these scattered showers that are in the Twin Cities right now. Those will push into our forecast late tonight and into tomorrow. But certainly looks gloomy. Waukesha getting a bit of a rain shower starting to push into Waukesha County. A little bit heavier downpour expected to go through the city in the next 10 minutes or so. But really, yeah, want to have the umbrella handy. And take a look at some of these rainfall totals already. About almost 3/4 of an inch in Port Washington, 6/500 of an inch in Sheboygan, about an inch in Racine as well as in Kenosha, just because some of those showers and thunderstorms from Chicago clipped you guys earlier. And of course, with the rain, we have the colder temps. 52 degrees right now in Milwaukee. This time yesterday, we were around 80 degrees. Quite the drop. 67 though in Burlington and 68 in Lake Geneva, even 73 right now in Janesville. So a few areas still holding on to some of the warmer air, but 58 in Fond du Lac, the cold air is coming. Here's a bigger picture, a look at this system. It extends all the way down into portions of Alabama and Mississippi. This is that same storm system that did produce that big twister in Moore, Oklahoma. And again, was rated EF5, peak wind speeds over 200 miles an hour. We have had our share of EF5s here in southeastern Wisconsin, or not in southeastern Wisconsin, in the entire state of Wisconsin. Six of them, only two officially declared an EF5 by the National Weather Service. That was Oakfield and the Barneveld one, but six of them total going back to the 1800s. No severe weather for us, though. Again, just rain showers throughout the overnight hours. Still a few lingering showers tomorrow morning. Tomorrow, though, you'll notice the cold and the wind. The wind will be nasty. It is going to be a raw day throughout your Thursday. Cooler temps, highs only in the 50s, and we stay in the 50s as we go into your Friday. But the good thing for the forecast, the winds calm down thanks to high pressure, and that will allow sunshine to return to the forecast as well. For tonight, though, could see an additional 1/4 inch of rain. Overnight lows seasonable around 47 degrees. Then tomorrow, note that wind from the north northeast, 15 to 20, gusting to 30, 54 only for a high. It is going to be chilly. Hope you didn't put away your fall coat. And then we get a little bit warmer on Friday. Lighter winds, though, 60s by Saturday, and that's still looking like the peak day out of Memorial Day weekend, with scattered chances for rain Sunday and into Monday.
A Tuesday never looks so good.
70. Hey, yeah, we do get warmer.
Thanks, Jess.
Eventually.